There's just enough bullshit to hold things together in this country. Bullshit is the glue that binds us as a nation. Where would we be without our safe, familiar American bullshit? Land of the free, home of the brave, the American dream. All men are equal, justice is blind, the press is free, your vote counts. Business is honest, the good guys win, the police are on your side, God is watching you, your standard of living will never decline, and everything is gonna be just fine. The official national bullshit story.
We live in a sick society. We pollute the air, the water, our soil for so-called profit, and we are slowly destroying the planet we inhabit. We live in a sick society. Our law enforcement officers kill unarmed people every single day, predominantly black. And then when criticized about it, they blame the victims. And sadly, so do many citizens. What? What? So I'm racist and so I shot this thug? Who cares? Their lives don't matter. All that matters is that I get home without any inconvenience. We live in a sick society. Terrorists can walk into any gun store in the country and purchase a pure killing machine. But Black Lives Matter cannot protest in the streets. How dare they assert their freedom of speech? They're the real terrorists. We live in a sick society where alcohol is a social gathering necessity encouraged everywhere, despite killing so many people each year. Marijuana, on the other hand, has not killed anybody ever, and it actually treats many ailments along with containing cancer-fighting properties. But it's a Schedule I drug deemed to have no medical qualities at all. We live in a sick society. We're going $60,000 in debt for colleges just the way it is, where the poor are demonized and the rich are something to aspire to. We live in a sick society.
I mean, everything that we introduce to the world is shitty. Meaning white people. Because I really think that white people are from like another planet. Because we, like, when we came to America, it was so nice. It was just Indians. And they weren't even Indians. We called them that by accident. And we still call them that. Like, we knew in a month that it wasn't Indians, but we just don't give a shit. We never correct it. We came here, they're like, hi, and we're like, hey, you're Indians, right? And they're like, no. No, this is India, right? No, it's not, it's a totally other place. You're not Indians? No. Ah, you're Indians.
Look around the world. We are living in a grandeur time in human history. Life expectancy has doubled in the last 200 years. We have the means to travel anywhere on the globe in a relatively short amount of time. We have televisions, AC, amusement parks, virtual reality, and the internet. But look past all this technological achievement, and you'll see the grim reality of the world. The fact that one person dies every 4 seconds from hunger-related causes, mostly children. The fact that there's more slavery today than at any time in human history. The fact that 62 people in the world have as much wealth as the bottom 50%. The fact that every time a government takes out a loan from a bank, it has to be paid back with interest, which essentially doesn't exist. The fact that it takes years and years to build up credit, but only one loan default for it to be pushed down forever. The fact that politics gives us the illusion of choice, but in fact we have no say at all, and never really have. So the real question is, what the hell is the problem?
Do you know what a duvet is? Guys like you and I know what a duvet is. Is this essential to our survival in the hunter-gatherer sense of the word? No. What are we then?
Consumers.
Right. We are consumers. We are byproducts of a lifestyle obsession. Murder, crime, poverty, these things don't concern me. What concerns me are celebrity magazines, television with 500 channels, some guy's name on my underwear. Rogaine, Viagra, Olestra.
Martha Stewart.
Martha's polishing the brass on the Titanic. It's all going down, man. I say never be complete. I say stop being perfect. I say let's evolve. chips fall where they may. That's me, and I could be wrong. Maybe it's a terrible tragedy.
Nah, it's just stuff. Not tragedy.
Well, you did lose a lot of versatile solutions for modern living.
Nah, that's me. My insurance is probably gonna cover it. So. What?
The things you own end up owning you.
A socioeconomic system driven by competition, self-maximization, and a need to preserve scarcity is not sustainable. That tendency to consolidate power, monopolize, and gain advantage over others at the expense of others has always been there in society, and it will always be there. It's psychological. We cannot control it as long as we're in this system. The funniest myth to me is that we're free, that America is a free country. That's just hilarious. Here's something about freedom. However free one thinks they are, it's always in contradiction to others' freedom to restrict your freedom. And bad news, that always prevails. Now, means of exchange or trade was a contrivance by human beings in an attempt to understand and figure out the world. It's been with us for thousands of years and has given birth to all the suffering, manipulation, and coercion our history has seen. And unless we change it, then it will likely be our demise. Luckily, unlike past times, we have the ability to do things like feed everyone on the planet, clean water for everyone, clean energy, place to live, access to basically anything one would want. With things like vertical farms, desalination processes, wind, solar, geothermal energy, 3D printing, maglev trains, the solutions are there. We as a species need to recognize that we cannot continue to run around playing games with each other, blowing each other up, hoarding wealth, hoarding the means to wealth, polluting the air and water, and halting progress if we expect to survive. And for people who claim we're competitive by nature and we can't change this, think a little bit harder. If we live in a system that perpetually reinforces in its structure alone things like self-preservation, self-interest, everyone's out for themselves, then the competitive-minded individual will be dominant in society every single time. This is a matter of waking people up. Change won't happen through politics or religion or the economy we perpetuate today. Real change happens when the masses, large amounts of people all around the globe, stand up and demand it. Only then will the power establishment and the elites of our world get the message. The power is in the people, and it always has been.
America's opportunity to help bridge the gulf between the haves and the have-nots. And the question is whether America will do it. There's nothing new about poverty. What is new is that we now have the techniques and the resources to get rid of poverty. And the real question is whether we have the will.